So, this evening I'm gonna talk a little bit about particles. Okay, no, don't presume I am Mrs. Scientist here, but I know certain logic that I've heard throughout the years, okay, that we have these particles. And now, these particles, they come from all the planets. They come from Jupiter and Mars, and they come from Venus, and they come from the Sun. They come from Pluto, they come from Mercury, okay, and their moons as well. All of this little cosmic dust, it goes into particle form, okay. I think I lost my sound, didn't I? No, okay, yeah. It goes off into particle form. And these particles, they travel not just to Earth, you know, hey, big attractant here. It's not just the attractant of magnetic pull to Earth, because actually our magnetic pull is not very high compared to Jupiter. Jupiter is 40 times higher than us. So theoretically, if we lose our atmosphere, we would, you know, really get become like a magnetic attraction and just get sunk in to become a moon, one of Jupiter's moons. That would be awful. Anyway, I think I have bad sound. It's all glippy. But, dang it. I have to look at this thing for a moment. It's not supposed to be bad sound. Alright. So, so we have these particles, and they're going zoom, zoom, zoom through. And they're traveling to Earth. They're traveling past Earth. They're going millions and millions of miles away, and they are attracted to this live energy, humans, live energy animals, live energy, all of this planet, you know, they're just attracted. So these particles go right through and they mix in the interchange, and then they just keep going. So if we think of ourselves as a pass-through medium, you know, that we're not really, if we think of ourselves more as an ethereal body rather than a present and fleshy one, like if you just lie completely still, you can imagine yourself hovering in a levitational form, that you actually are all space all around you, you know, just like you are your own entire planet. Okay, so here you are, your own entire planet, and these particles, if you calm down, get into your meditation, if you just listen to the incoming and the outgoing, not your brain, not what your mind is saying, if you just try, because they're very vibrant, it is a vibe effect, they really go through your body. Okay, it's just like chi, just like the chi. Alright, so when all of this is going on, we're having a transfer moment. And if you're in a really, really good state, your body is just like a waterfall. The particles go through one way and then they waterfall out the other, you know. If you're not in a good state though, so we're talking, I'm getting into health and effects on the health, like you're thinking you're in an angry mode and you're gripping your muscles. You're tight in your heart, you're just like gritting your teeth or something. When any of that type of action is happening, you have to think of these little innocent particles coming your way, you know. They're going to come and mix with your space. These little innocent particles are going to be like, whoa, don't go that direction. It's like a traffic jam. That energy that woman is gripping at, you know, in her cheek or whatever, she has a snarl, all of those, that moment, that muscle energy is a place where the particles are not going to have as fun and easy a time flowing through, okay? And the whole point of getting to our utopia and getting to the state of enlightened being is to allow this flow through to go on, you know, let it all happen, not be like, hey, no, block, you know, here's a block. And so these poor little innocents are like, oh, I don't want to go that way, because they get there and they get all clustered and then they have to go travel around, you know, it's just like yucky. So they have to travel around. And so then thus a waterfall event happens in other areas in your body. And they're the particle waterfall. This is my theory, of course. But yeah, so now particle waterfalls are happening because you have angst and you have a negative, you're flexing your foot too hard, you know, and you're just not relaxed. And my theory is they really flow through better when you're completely relaxed. We're having a better throughput. And if you look at these little guys, like getting a bath, being washed, getting a fresh health wave, you know, they're just little things like this that go all the way around, and they just keep having it's a vibration when they hit each other, and that's all they are, just like fluttering around, and they just want to flutter through you. That's it. And you have yours also. We all have our own, but what happens is they interchange. They meet along the way, and then some of the ones we've had a while expel and get taken out with them, you know, with the new ones, or the new ones stay. You know, all of this is happening. So my whole entire theory is about this tension. If we can bring our tension, bring our anxiety, bring our even our mind ego. Our mind ego, if you ever seen like an auric camera, an event, even your mind, while you're thinking mind thoughts, your aura changes. Okay, so this is all having like an effect. So if you're having like a real Grummian type of a mean thought about a person or something, or a self-pity moment, you know, oh, why is this happening to me? All of that, you know, all of that. If you're having that in your brain, the same deal. Your particles are going to be like, well, I was headed to her brain, and I'm like, I don't really want to go there anymore. There's just a traffic jam. There's gripping going on just in those little diodes in the brain there, those synapsis zones. It's not as fun. You know, they're gonna go another way. And thusly, they create a waterfall even here. Let's say they don't go into that section of my brain, they end up over here in my cheek. And so I end up with too many going through my cheek. I know this sounds absurd, but just you watch, you know, 100 years from now, they'll prove it. And they'll be like, you should have listened to her. You should have listened to her. All of our health, all of our free, and let's talk about free. This is something free. Nobody charges. It's absolutely available to anybody who wants it. Anytime, day or night. So there is no government out there that is saying there's a tax on it. It's yours. It's yours. Yours to claim. Those little particles. Okay, so when it's Jupiter's is giving off extra star magic, star particles, get those. When off it goes to Uranus, get those. When it gets, you know, don't lose out. You know what I mean? We're just a big health wish-wash here, you know? So don't lose out on those when the time comes from them to vorb through you. You know what I'm saying? I think everybody understands, but my big theory is I'm a little worried about, I shouldn't worry because that already creates a traffic jam for them, but I'm a little worried about the waterfall effect. You know, when you've created the tension zone, and then they go to a waterfall area, like here in my cheek, because you see it's all hot. Let's say they're all going there, because I've already done this test, and I've already gripped in certain areas, and I've already felt the movement to another area where it was more, and it all of a sudden started tingling. So I already know this happens just from, if you really are in tune with your body. But so the cheek itself is now getting this waterfall, and it's like, oh my God, maybe that's just too much. You know, it's not supposed to just get a blast through. You know, it's about quantity and quality and all of that. So I don't know. So that's where I'm at right now, was with the particle accelerators through us, essentially. You know? And let's have fun. So because we are stars, you know, we're interchanging with stars constantly. It's just beautiful. If you look at yourself that way, it's really a beautiful thing. And so when you have criticism coming at you from another person, be aware of how it makes you feel, how you're gripping in your body from that criticism. Be aware of it. Be aware of what it's doing to your face or a muscle somewhere on your body. And when that criticism, it almost like you turn a mirror right around those people and go, oh my gosh, you can almost see the little stars going like, how do we get through that person? How can we get through them? They're going to end up with just a waterfall in their foot. You know what I'm saying? And the whole rest of their body is going to be missed. So let's try to be complete and allow our entire bodies to accept the stars. All right. Because we are stars. All right. And that's it. And I also learned that from a TV show that was brought on by scientists, so it's not just in my brain fed to you. It was on a real live scientist TV show.